गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट द थर्ड सेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर नेचुरल एंड मैन मेड डिजास्टर। एंड इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द फायर हैजर्ड्स। रिसेंटली इन द इंटरनेशनल न्यूज, टुडेज इंटरनेशनल न्यूज, इफ यू चेक इट, यू विल फाइंड दैट हाउ अ वेरी डिवेस्टेटेड फायर स्प्रेड इन द फॉरेस्ट, इन द लार्ज एरिया ऑफ फॉरेस्ट इन कैलिफोर्निया एंड USA. And this forest fire is very difficult to control, and so all the personals, means the people who are responsible to control the fire, they are trying to their best to control the fire, but expanding. So as you can find, the forest fire, if you'll find time to time, it's very very common, especially on the international forum. And this forest fire can be seen in United States of America, then in some months back, last year, it was in Amazon forest also, in Africa also, large area of forest, time to time, it catches fire, in Australia also, just last year it happened, and in Europe also. So in different parts of the world, especially in the temperate region, the forest fires are very, very common, and we have seen the consequences of this fire. But here in this chapter, we are going to see about the fire hazards usually, which affect the urban areas, and which usually destroys the houses and the property, and the life has been affected. So let's see here about the fire hazard. So this fire hazard, as you can see, time to time, it is very very common. Large number of people have been killed in the past, and it has been seen that it's very very difficult actually to control this fire, because once the fire just spreads, and what happens is till the fire brigade comes there to control the fire, it just spreads and destroys a large property, and so many people, they have been killed. Well, so this is why it's important to have some fire safety measures. And this is why time to time you can find in the schools and the colleges, in the different organizations, there are the, especially the people from the fire brigade, they used to time to time they train the people, the students and the children and the different people working in the different organizations. Why? So that the common people also, they can know about how to use the fire safety measures. So let's see here and check it, that what are the fire safety measures and what things we need to do, especially during the fire, when sometimes a fire broke out. So what we need to do it. So you can find, first of all, in this figure 5.9, there is a one house is given here, and you can find this is written here, emergency evacuation plan. And you can find in every room there is a one exit door is given here, window or either door is given here, and usually it is constructed. Why? So that during such type of disaster, the people, they can quickly evacuate the house. Well, now beside this, there are some more measures is taken. That the first one is the smoke detectors. Now these smoke detectors are the special type of instrument which are usually fixed in the different parts of the houses. Especially it is used in the big malls and the industries and the factories which were having the very very big buildings, because it is very very difficult to evacuate such a big building quickly. And so in the different parts, in different corners, the smoke detectors are fixed. Now what happens in a time of, especially during the time of the fire just broke out, this type of disaster, so what happened, this smoke detector, it detects the smoke and it has one alarm, and what happened, it starts just sounding in a very very high noise, loud noise actually, it starts ringing, and this is how the people, they come to know that something has happened, and quickly the people evacuate that place. Next is the fire prevention strategy. Now what are the fire prevention strategy? Now this thing can be seen even in our school. If you check in every corner, time to at a certain distance, there are the fire extinguishers are fixed. The same way in houses also, especially near the kitchen and such places where the fire are very very common, so the fire extinguisher should be fixed, and every year these fire extinguisher should be checked. So this is how whenever the fire broke out, so the people, they can use this fire extinguisher. Second thing, the children also should be trained, especially the in the use of matches and the fire and the electrical outlets and the electrical cords and stoves and the chemicals which can actually lead to the fire hazard. So especially the children, because they are more vulnerable to these such type of disaster. So this training should be given to the children also. Then the third point is, the third important thing is the family fire drill. Especially in the big apartments where the many people, many families, they live together, because buildings are so big, it is of multi story, and that's why during the such type of incident it can be very very difficult to evacuate the building very quickly. And so the people, they should have fire drill practice at least once in a year. Now what is this fire drills practice? Now in this, usually the children, maybe the not only the children but also the old people, every people, they just take part in this drill, and they practice actually that when the alarm rings, what should they do, how they evacuate the place, or what thing they used to carry with them, or where they can hide, or sometimes if a person catches fire, what should they do if the, suppose their clothes just catches fire. Now in order to just spread the, just controlling the spread of the fire, what they need to do. So these type of training should be given to every person, means not only children but old people and every people, actually they should be take part in such type of drill. And especially those people who are living in the big apartments and the big buildings, and the family is very big, and buildings are also very big, and in such type of cases it is difficult to get out or get evacuated from the building. So these type of drills are very very important. Well, next is the potential fire hazard. Now usually what we should do during this type of fire hazard. Now because these fire, they can broke anywhere, anytime, without any notice, period notice. So now usually if you'll find, the first thing is, we should keep our eye especially on the cooking, means the kitchen, gas stove, plastic, matches. Now these are the things which usually starts the fire. The fire explodes or starts especially by these things or places like kitchen. So we should be very very careful especially. Next is, we should make sure that the cigarette butts are fully extinguished before emptying the ashtrays. So usually some people are having the habit, those especially who smoke. So what happened, they just throw the butt, that is still it is burning, they throw anywhere, but usually in the house they keep it in the ashtray. But the thing is, these ashtrays are emptied at any place, and still suppose the some ashes, some fire is still there, and suppose these ashtrays are emptied at some place, at some garbage where especially the garbage is dry, or the grasses are there, or maybe some such type of things which can catch fire. So such type of things should be taken into care. Next, now avoid the fireworks. Especially we should avoid the fireworks, especially in the house. Inside the house, first of all, you can't see. Nobody used to use these fireworks. Well, But especially in the Deepavali, this firework is very, very common. But the thing is, the first important thing is that we should take all the safety measure. And when we are dealing with the firework. Next is, the owner of the house, and usually the person who builds the house, or suppose some people, they comes there to live, and they are new for that building, and as they are living there on rent, so they are not knowing everything about that building. So the house owner, they should show this type of this the whole house plan, especially to the people who are living there on rent, so that during this time actually these people, they can easily evacuate that house. Next is, for the preparation of the fire safety plan, the owner of the house, he should ensure that all the visitor and the people there living in that house, they should be informed. Suppose if the house is very big, especially this is talking about the big apartments. Now they are having so many flats, and usually you will find most of the apartments is owned by some people. And most of the flats are given on rent. So most of the people living in the big apartments are living on rent. Well, and especially in that case, actually, the people are not knowing everything about that building. So in that case, the house owner, the owner of that whole apartment, he has the duty, and he should ensure that every person and even the staff working there in the apartment, they should know about everything. And especially in the case of this fire hazard, if it breaks there, so every person, they should be informed. So this type of preparation should be done by the house owner. The last thing, now during a fire emergency, the safety plan must be available for the responding the fire department use. Now especially in the big building, this is talking about especially about the school buildings and the factory and the apartments. Now you will find most of the factories or the school buildings and maybe especially in the apartments on the ground floor, there is a whole plan is given, that map of that whole building is laid up there, every gallery, everything, and especially it is done for the people from the fire department. So suppose if the building catches fire, so these people, when they comes there, so only by looking the map, everything, they may know about the everything, about every room and everything, that how they should make the plan to just take their steps to control the fire. So these are some potential fire hazards, some steps, very important steps should be taken during the fire hazard. Now next is the disaster management in India. Now what is the meaning of disaster management? Now usually if you'll find, every year the natural and the man-made disasters, they kill millions of people all over the world, and it just causes tremendous loss to the life and the property, and also the ecosystem even. So this is why the different countries, they have been focusing on the emergency response forward thing, that is the dealing with this such type of disasters. So whenever this type of disasters occurs, usually most of the countries, they are having the emergency response, so emergency backup plan. But still there is a need of what thing, the prevention and mitigation of natural disaster. So prevention and mitigation means, so even before we should have some emergency plan, we should have some big backup plan. And there is a separate task force should be prepared in order to work during the time of disaster. So this is why the different countries, they are working on this. And the different countries, by their own ways, they have prepared such different type of disasters management plans. So usually these disaster management is a teamwork first of all, and you will find this disaster management plan, it contains the people from every sector. Means the people not only from the fire brigade, but the people from the police, from the army, from the government ministries, organizations, schools and the colleges, from not only the students, the old people also are involved in it, the whole society is involved in it, even the common man. So from common man to the government, right, every person is involved in it, and in this such type of programs, so government tries to just train different types of people in the different organization, in the different sector, so that in the time of need, whenever such different type of natural disaster hit any place or any region or country, so all the people, they can come together and they can help in such type of such incidents. So this is the need of the time. And let's see here, the next thing is the common objective during the any disaster. Yeah, usually in any type of disaster, there are, you will find some of the things usually is very, very common. Example, let's see here. Now, look here, either it is a earthquake or a flood or landslide or maybe cyclone. So these are all the natural disasters. So any type of such type of disasters, whenever they hit any place, so usually large number of people, they die, get injured, and many people, they just lose their homes. Well, now what happens there in this type of incidents, usually we face a very common type of things. Example, the first thing, moving the injured and affected people to the safe shelter. In all these disaster, large number of people get injured or affected, and the first thing is to take these people to the safe shelter. Second thing, providing the immediate first aid to the victims. So the medical facilities is to be provided. Now this is required in all types of disasters. Third is providing food and safe drinking water to the people who are living in the shelter. So you have seen time to time in the past, whenever Gorakhpur is hit by the flood, we have seen flood hitting Gorakhpur, and we have seen that how actually the different schools and even the universities, it was all turned into a shelter place, and the people, they were brought there. So for some days they were kept there. Well, next is searching for and rescuing the injured, buried people, especially during the earthquake and landslide. Now, especially during the earthquake, usually what happens, sometimes a large number of houses, they collapsed and many people, they just are buried. Now, there is a need, urgent need to just take them out and take them to the shelter place, safe place. And if they are injured, they should be given a proper treatment. Then next is providing the financial help, transport facilities, and giving support for the rehabilitation and recovery of the people. Now people, they saw different types of all the natural disaster, what happened, large number of people, their property is affected, their house is destroyed, their everything is lost. So the thing is, they need the rehabilitation. So the government should keep some of money, there is some fund should be prepared especially, so that during this time of disaster, these people, they can be helped financially in the rehabilitation and in supporting these people. So these are the common things can be seen, which is usually carried in all of the disaster. So whenever the management program is prepared, so we can keep in mind such type of things, because these are the common steps, the common things can be seen. So keeping all these things in the mind, a common program can be prepared. Now next is the role of government. Now during the such type of disaster, what is the role of government? Now, usually, if you find already we have discussed that how the environmental degradation actually and the disaster both are very closely connected. They are interlinked. And moreover, we can say that the disasters, most of the disasters, they are usually are the consequences of the environmental degradation. So this is the thing actually, keeping in mind this thing, the first thing if you'll find, the first duty of the government is to prepare a awareness program among the common people so that they can just help, especially in the enrichment of the environment, not the degradation. Well, so let's see here. So the first thing is the, as we have discussed, the first step for the government is to find out, to finding out the root of the problem. So this is the success of disaster. The success of disaster management, it depends upon the first thing, that is finding out the root of the problem that caused the disaster. Now example, if you'll find, most of the natural disasters, they are being caused by the deforestation. As every year large areas of forest has been cut, and this is why this cutting of the forestation, we also call it deforestation, it is affecting into different types of natural disaster. So this is the root cause. So the first thing, now it is very difficult to just again replanting or growing again the plants. So that is can be very, very difficult. But one thing the government can do, the government can create a awareness program so that the people can get aware of it and they help in the, in what thing? In the enrichment of the environment. So they can, well, now next is the government of India, along with the United Nations Development Program, which is called the UNDP. So together they have formulated one disaster risk management program in between 2002 and 2007. Government of India and the UNDP, together they have prepared this disaster program. Now this disaster program, it emphasizes especially in laying down what thing? Preparing the communities which can face the various type of hazards by generating awareness. This is why one thing if you will find, you are studying the environmental education. Previously environmental education was one subject, but as the students they were getting too much burden. So this subject has been removed, but now the portion of the environmental education, some portion is being included in every subject. So this is why in bio, maybe in botany or zoology, even in chemistry, even in physics and also in geography. So in all the subjects, usually you can find different type of portion from the environmental education. And even in the language like the English and Hindi also, some small chapters is added there that usually is means especially on the environmental education, some stories or maybe some poetry or prose is added. Now this is why it has been done, so that awareness program, that awareness can be created at the grassroots level. Grassroots level means from the childhood, the children, they should be trained. Now next is, now there should be a special training should be imparted to the disaster management personnel. Now the people who are working in this disaster management program, right, these people, they should be given a special training. And this is being done by the NDMF. NDMF is National Disaster Management Framework. Now this is usually prepared by the Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA. So they are responsible for imparting the training especially to these disaster management personnels. Without a proper training, they can't help in any type of disaster management. Now, so the NDM, that is the National Disaster Management, right? So they guides everything. Now what they do? Already we have seen NDMF, right? So NDM, that is the same thing, National Disaster Management, right? So this is the body. Okay, well, so this, they are responsible for guiding what thing? Look here, let's see here one by one. First thing, training of the engineers, architects and masons, especially in what thing? In safe construction practices, so that all the buildings should be built and constructed in one criteria, so that the building should be strong and safe even during the earthquake. Then the disaster management has been included as a core subject in the school curriculum of all the educational boards. Now you are studying this thing. In this chapter, you are studying about the disaster management. Why you are studying? Because it is included in every school, in every different subjects, right? It is included. That's why you are studying it in geography here. Maybe in other subjects also, you may see some small part. So that's why this thing is included in the curriculum of the school. Now the last topic is the role of remote sensing satellites in the natural disasters. Now usually the, what is the remote sensing? Remote sensing is a new technology in which by the help of satellites, so the whole region in the country can be watched. Now usually the satellites, they are having a very strong cameras. So by the help of the camera, the photography is being done. Now this is called aerial photography. So the aerial photography which is being taken by the satellites, it gives a clear picture at what is happening in the different parts of our country or different parts of the world. So this is known as the remote sensing. So by the help of the satellites, when everything is being watched properly, right, and the report is being given time to time, and it is, so this is known as the remote sensing. Now what happens in the remote sensing? So it is not only the cameras are there and only the satellites, they take picture. No, the satellites have the different types of instruments. Now the different types of instrument, they just work in different manner. So in a one type of thing, they have electromagnetic energy. So the satellites, they release the electromagnetic energy which is reflected back, and as they reflect back, so they just takes the not only picture but many things, the different type of data is collected. So by the help of satellites, now the people, they can even find out that what minerals are lies there inside the ground. By the help of satellites, even the water level inside the ground and all the water available there in different parts of our country can be taken into notice. So, and not only this, there are the defense satellite. Now India is using this satellite for watching, just keeping the eye on the border. Not only the Pakistan border, but also on the China-India border also. They are just tracing everything and keeping the eye there, what the Chinese military is doing. And recently you can find so many things in the news. So the satellites can be used in so many purpose. And in fact, there is a one branch now in geography which deals with the study of this thing. So this is known as the GIS and remote sensing. GIS means the Geographical Information System, and remote sensing is a separate branch now. It is the latest branch of geography, and it is not only a branch of geography, but also the science people, the students who have studied the science, especially by the physics. So either you have a graduate in physics or in geography, so you can take this course. Even the ISRO also have introduced different type of such type of courses which provides the training for the remote sensing. Well, so this is about the remote sensing. now especially the satellite images which help in the conservation of the environment. It just has a different ways. Let's see here one by one. First thing, unplanned deforestation can be checked and prevented. So by the help of the satellites, the unplanned deforestation can be controlled. Now second thing, by the help of the satellite, that is remote sensing, desertification can be checked from the advancing, as the satellite image will be at once reveal the overgrazing, felling of the trees and the water logging. Now what is the desertification? Desertification means even the deserts are expanding their areas. That is called the desertification, and this is why to stop this desertification, the government, they usually plant the belt of trees on the border of the desert so that the velocity of the wind can be checked. So this is how, by the help of satellites, even the desertification can be checked. Then the third is the degraded land can be identified by the satellite images. Now there are so many areas I explained in the, actually not in your class, in the other classes. So I explained that how the different parts in our country, there are so many land which is actually have degraded, means the land has lost its fertility. So by the help of satellites, these type of degraded land can be identified, and the different steps can be taken in order to improve the quality of that land. Next is the, by the help of satellites, even the floods and the flood prone areas can be detected. So the satellites can give a clear picture, especially of the region of the floods and the flood prone areas. So clear pictures can be taken, clear idea, the clear things. Next is assessment of drought condition can be done by using information about the rainfall. Now the satellites also, as I told you, it is not only used for taking the aerial photograph, but the satellites can be used for so many purpose, collecting the weather data, different weather datas. It is used for so many things in the defense sector. Even now the industries are using it, right? So in the agriculture also, the satellites are being used. Israel actually is using satellites even in the field of agriculture. Now in even India, they are also started using this. Well, the thing is, even the, just to assess the drought condition, droughts are very, very common in some parts of our country. So in this case, the information that can be collected about the rainfall, the previous information from that, actually one idea can be prepared, and before the drought occurs in any region, so some steps can be taken, especially in those places. Next is the last one. The remote sensing is used to assess the damage done by the intense mining and excavations, especially during the mining and the excavations. So usually large damage has been done to the environment. So the satellites can be used in those areas also, just to assess the damage which has been done there. So in order to just take the different steps to improve the thing there. So this is the thing, and this chapter is over now, natural disaster. But only this chapter is finished. Now this chapter includes so many case study. Already you can find it in your book. So we'll start afterwards. So all of you, find out the answers given there, the question which is given in your book. So find out the answer. So all the best, all of you.